Morning to everybody. Today is the 19th of February 2020 and I'm back today delighted to be able to share with you a really very encouraging word and message from the Lord. Now I prayed for this for my YouTube family about four nights ago. I went to bed and I said, Lord, I've had to deliver so many serious messages lately. Could you give me something really encouraging for my YouTube family? And he was true and good, and he did that immediately that night. And as it happens, brothers and sisters, just as I sat down this morning, I realized that that night was the 14th of February, Valentine's Day. And this message is a message of love for his bride, and it's so encouraging. So how appropriate for the day of love, the 14th of February, Valentine's Day. And the reason I haven't shared it with you yet, I've been really wanting to, is that there were other messages that I felt were actually really important that I had to put out first. But today's the day, and fantastic, I can't wait to share this with you. Now, the reason I'm showing you a pearl is the vision started with pearls being passed from hand to hand. And the pearls were a similar colour to this, but more silvery grey. This one has got quite green highlights. Aren't pearls just absolutely beautiful? And I want to share with you some scriptures about the pearls of great price, and other just really important messages from scripture about pearls and what they signify in the Bible. But first, let's go on with a picture that will help you to understand what I saw in the vision. So here we are. In the vision, I saw a jewellery workshop and there were busy hands, just like this. This is about the perspective that I had. There were hands and pearls, and these beautiful silver pearls, many of them, were being passed from hand to hand as they were worked on in this jewellery workshop. And I had the sense that it was a very big order and that these people were very busy, but they were also exceedingly careful with the pearls, and they were sorting them, and it was a labor of love. And that was pretty much the end of the vision. There were many pearls, brothers and sisters, and they were all beautiful. But that wasn't the end of the message, because as soon as the vision finished, I was given the name Toby. And I had no idea what Toby meant, but I knew because it was so random that this was important and I needed to look up the meaning. And at the same time, in my half sleep, I remember thinking that Toby was the jeweler. So with great delight, I'm going to share with you what Toby means. So here we are, everyone, and wouldn't you know it, the Toby derives from Hebrew. Fancy that. Oh, the Lord is good. And it's short for the word Tobiah, Tobiyahu, or Tobiah, spelt differently. And it means Yahweh is good. It means the goodness of God, and it also means pleasing to the Lord. And I think these pearls were pleasing to the Lord, and these pearls represent you, brothers and sisters, the bride of Christ. So just going over that again, Toby means Yahweh is good, the goodness of God, pleasing to the Lord. Isn't that fantastic? Now, when I woke up the next morning, I immediately thought of another vision that the Lord gave me on the 16th of April 2019, last year. And I've just gone back in my journal to show you this entry. And I believe that I may have done a video about this one as well. But I'll just read what my journal says. It says, I was just awaking after being asleep for a few hours and I saw a beautiful ring. Very unique. It seemed that the band was made of finely turned wood that was light in colour. There were two strips of wood and a pearl on top, and it was exquisite. And I prayed about what the ring signified, and this is the words of the Lord in pink. He told me, the ring signifies Christ's promise. Christ promised to come for his bride, the church, those who have put their trust in him as their Saviour. So, brothers and sisters, as you see from that message last year, the Lord said to me those words, the ring signifies Christ's promise. And that is something that I feel is really particularly relevant to this video today. Those pearls were part of God's promise to his bride. And the fact that that jewelry shop was so busy, the Lord is preparing for the return of his bride. Those pearls are the pearls of great price to the Lord, those pleasing to the Lord, like the word Toby. So, brothers and sisters, I want to look at a few scriptures about the promise God has made. Now, this is Isaiah 54, starting at verse 5. Let's read that together. It's in the King James Version today. For your Maker is your husband. The Lord of hosts is his name, and your Redeemer is the Holy One of Israel. He is called the God of the whole earth. For the Lord has called you, like a woman forsaken and grieved in spirit, like a youthful wife when you were refused, says your God. For a mere moment I have forsaken you, but with great mercies I will gather you. Oh, isn't that an amazing scripture for this particular vision? He is our husband. And at the end, it speaks, because of his great mercies, he will gather us. And the next reading I want to do is Revelation 19, starting from verse 7. Let us be glad and rejoice and give him glory, for the marriage of the Lamb has come and his wife has made herself ready. That is all the believers in Jesus Christ, brothers and sisters. That is you. And to her it was granted to be arrayed in fine linen, clean and bright, for the fine linen is the righteous acts of the saints. Didn't we speak of the fruit yesterday, brothers and sisters? Verse 9, then he said to me, write, blessed are those who are called to the marriage supper of the Lamb. And he said to me, these are the true sayings of God. And this is from Revelation 22, starting at verse 12, the words of Jesus in red, and behold, I am coming quickly, and my reward is with me, to give to everyone according to his work. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Just skipping along to verse 17, just for time reasons, but please go back and read the whole thing. And the Spirit and the Bride say, come, and let him who hears say, come, and let him who thirsts come. And whoever desires, let him take the water of life freely. And I'm just going to skip down again, brothers and sisters, to verse 20, where it says, he who testifies to these things says, surely I am coming quickly. Amen. Even so, come, Lord Jesus. I really think the Lord loves it when we say, come, Lord Jesus, we are waiting for you. Now, brothers and sisters, in that first vision that I had in the workshop, there were many pearls, because that is the Lord showing us that he is getting ready for all of us. But you may feel, oh, maybe my value's not so great. Don't you believe it? You might be like this solitary pearl on this beautiful shell. But you are a pearl of great price, and that is spoken of in Matthew chapter 13, and I'm just going to read those scriptures to you. So Matthew chapter 13, verse 45 says, "Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant seeking beautiful pearls, who, when he had found one pearl of great price, went and sold all that he had and brought it." Brothers and sisters, I believe the Lord showed us pearls because of the value that the Bible seems to give pearls, and because of this beautiful verse, "You are the beautiful pearls that the Lord has sought. He has found you and called you by name, and you are a pearl of great price. Don't ever believe anything else." And isn't the Lord a pearl of great price to us too? Once we have found him, we never want to let him go. That is the Lord Jesus. So what a beautiful word from our Lord. And I thought it was really interesting that the Lord, when in the first vision that I was given, he showed me a ring made of wood. Now, I just wouldn't even conceive seeing a pearl on a ring made of beautiful laminated wood. It was exquisite in that it was made of two different layers of wood, one set inside the other. And I just love the way the Lord surprises me with things like that. And this is why he's just reinforcing that first vision that he gave me of the ring. And I believe that that symbolizes the wedding. And what did the Lord say in that first vision? He said, "The ring signifies Christ's promise. His promise to us, the bride. He is not going to let us down." And that workshop was really busy, brothers and sisters. They are getting ready. So I hope this video really blesses you. It is a love letter from the Lord God, our Lord Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit for you on Valentine's Day. Bye for now.